Hi, and welcome to Bible Buddy. Today is day number 46, and we will be reading from 13 and 14, and let's pray. Dear God, thank you for this opportunity that we get to read together. Thank you for my online friends, and dear Lord, I ask that you open our eyes and our heart and our mind so that we can learn more from you. And I ask that the Holy Spirit would lead and guide and direct us while we're reading your word. And may you receive glory and honor in all that we say and do. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Okay, let's open up to Leviticus 13. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron, if anyone has a swelling or a rash or discolored skin that may develop into a serious skin disease, that person must be brought to Aaron, the priest, or to one of his sons. The priest will examine the affected area of the skin. If the hair in the affected area has turned white and the problem appears to be more than deep, it is a serious skin disease, and the priest who examines it must pronounce the person ceremonially unclean. But if the affected area of the skin is only a white discoloration and it does not appear to be more than skin deep, if the hair on the spot has not turned white, the priest will quarantine the person for 7 days. On the seventh day, the priest will make another examination. If he finds the affected area that has not changed and the problem has not spread on the skin, the priest will quarantine the person for 7 more days. And on the seventh day, the priest will make another examination. If he finds the affected area has faded or has not spread, the priest will pronounce the person ceremonially clean. It is only a rash. The person's clothing must be washed, and the person will be ceremonially clean. If the rash continues to spread after the person has been examined by the priest and has been pronounced clean, the infected person must return to be examined again. If the priest finds that the rash has spread, he must pronounce the person ceremonially unclean, for it is indeed a skin disease. Anyone who develops a serious skin disease must go to the priest for an examination. If the priest finds a white swelling on the skin, some hair on the spot has turned white, and there is an open sore in the affected area, it is a chronic skin disease, and the priest must pronounce the person ceremonially unclean. In such cases, the person need not be quarantined, for it is obvious that the person is defiled by the disease. Now, suppose the disease has spread all over the person's skin, covering the body from head to foot. When the priest examines the infected person and finds that the disease covers the entire body, he will pronounce the person ceremonially clean. Since the skin has turned completely white, the person is clean. But if any sores appear, the infected person will pronounce ceremonially unclean. The priest must make his pronouncement as soon as he sees an open sore, since open sores indicate the presence of skin disease. However, if the sore heals and turns white like the rest of the body, the person must return to the priest for another examination. If the affected areas have indeed turned white, the priest will then pronounce the person ceremonially clean by declaring, "You are clean." If anyone has a boil on the skin and that has started to heal, but a white swelling or a reddish white spot develop in its place, that person must go to the high priest to be examined. If the priest examines it and finds it to be more than skin deep, if the hair in the affected area has turned white, the priest must pronounce the person ceremonially unclean. The boil has become a serious skin disease. If the priest finds no white hair in the affected area and the problem appears to be more than skin deep and has faded, the priest must quarantine the person for 7 days. And during that time, the affected area spreads over the skin. The priest must pronounce the person ceremonially unclean because it is a serious disease. But if the area grows larger and does not spread, it is merely the scar from the boil, the priest will pronounce the person ceremonially clean. If anyone who suffered a burn from the skin in the burnt area changes color, becoming either reddish, white, or shiny white, the priest must examine it. If he finds that the hair in the affected area has turned white and the problem appears to be more than skin deep, the skin disease has broken out in turn. The priest must pronounce the person ceremonially unclean, for it is clearly a serious skin disease. But if the priest finds no white hair on the affected area and the problem appears to be more than skin deep and has faded, the priest must quarantine the infected person for 7 days. On the seventh day, the priest must examine the person again. If the affected area has spread on the skin, the priest must pronounce the person ceremonially unclean, for it is clearly a serious skin disease. But if the affected area has not changed or spread on the skin has faded, it is simply a swelling from the burn. The priest will then pronounce the person ceremonially clean, for it is only the scar from the burn. If anyone, either a man or a woman, has a sore on the head or chin, and the priest must examine it. If he finds it more than skin deep and has fine yellow hair on it, the priest must pronounce the person ceremonially unclean. It is a scabby sore of the head or chin. The priest examines the scabby sore and finds that it is only skin deep, but there is no black hair on it. He must quarantine the person for 7 days. On the seventh day, the priest must examine the sore again. If he finds that the scabby sore has not spread and there's no yellow hair on it, and it appears to be skin deep, the person must shave off all hair except the hair on the affected area. Then the priest must quarantine the person for another 7 days. On the seventh day, he will examine the sore again. If it has not spread and appears to be no more than skin deep, the priest will pronounce the person ceremonially clean. The person's clothing must be washed, and the person will be ceremonially clean. But if the scabby sore begins to spread after the person is pronounced clean, the priest must do another examination. If he finds that the sore has spread, the priest will not need to look for yellow hair. The infected person is ceremonially unclean, but if the color of the scabby sore does not change and the black hair has grown on it, it has healed. The priest will then pronounce the person ceremonially clean. If anyone, either a man or a woman, has shiny white patches on the skin, the priest must examine the affected area. If he finds that the shiny patches are only white pale, and this is a harmless skin rash, and the person is ceremonially unclean. If a man loses his hair and his head becomes bald, he is still ceremonially clean. But if he loses hair on his forehead and he simply has a bald forehead, he is still clean. However, the reddish-white sore appears on the bald area at the top or back of his head. This is a skin disease. The priest must examine him. And if he finds swelling around a reddish-white sore anywhere on a man's head and it looks like a skin disease, the man is indeed infected with a skin disease and it is unclean. The priest must pronounce him ceremonially unclean because of the sore on his head. Those who suffer from a serious skin disease must tear their clothing and leave their hair uncombed. They must cover their mouth and call out, "Unclean, unclean." As long as the serious skin lasts, they will be ceremonially unclean. They must live in isolation in their place outside the camp. Now suppose mildew contaminates some woolen or linen clothing, woolen or linen fabric, or hide of an animal, or anything of leather. If the contaminated area in the clothing, the animal hide, the fabric, and the leather article has turned greenish or reddish, it is contaminated with mildew and must be shown to the priest. After examining the affected spot, the priest will put the article in quarantine for 7 days. On the seventh day, the priest must inspect it again. If the contaminated area has spread, the clothing or fabric or leather is clearly contaminated by serious mildew and is ceremonially unclean. The priest must burn the item, the clothing, the woolen or the linen fabric, or piece of leather, for it has been contaminated by serious mildew. It must be completely destroyed by fire. But the priest examines it and finds it that the contaminated area has not spread the clothing, the fabric, and the leather. The priest will order the object to be washed and then quarantined for 7 more days. Then the priest must examine the object again. If he finds the contaminated area has not changed color after being washed, even if it did not spread, the object is defiled. It must be completely burned up, whether the contaminated spot is on the outer side or inside out. But if the priest examines it and finds it that the contaminated area has faded after being washed, he must cut the spot on the clothing, the fabric, or the leather. If the spot later reappears on the clothing, the fabric, on the leather article, the mildew is clearly spreading, the contaminated object must be burned up. If the spot disappears from the clothing, the fabric, or the leather articles after it has been washed, it must be washed again, then it will be ceremonially clean. These are the instructions for dealing with mildew that contaminates woolen or linen clothing or fabric or anything made of leather. This is how the priest will determine whether these items are ceremonially clean or unclean. Okay, chapter 14. And the Lord said to Moses, the following instructions are for those seeking ceremonial purification for skin disease. Those who have been healed must be brought to the priest, who will examine them at the place outside the camp. If the priest finds someone who has been healed of a serious skin disease, he will perform a purification ceremony using the 2 live birds that are ceremonially clean, a stick of cedar, some scarlet yarn, and a hyssop branch, or hyssop branch. The priest will order that one bird be slaughtered over a clay pot filled with fresh water. He will take the live bird, the cedar stick, the scarlet yarn, and the hyssop branch, and dip them into the blood of the bird that was slaughtered over the fresh water. The priest will then sprinkle the blood of the dead bird 7 times on the person being purified of skin disease. When the priest has purified the person, he will release the live bird in the open field to fly away. Then the persons being purified must then wash their clothes, shave off all their hair, and bathe themselves in water, and they will be ceremonially clean and may return to the camp. However, they must remain outside their tents for 7 days. On the 7th day, they must again shave all the hair from their heads, including the hair of the beard and eyebrows. They must also wash their clothes and bathe themselves in water, and then will be ceremonially clean. On the 8th day, the person being purified must bring 2 male lambs and 1 year old female lamb with no defects, along with the grain offering 6 quarts of choice flour moistened with olive oil and a cup of olive oil. Then the officiating priest will present the person for purification, along with the offerings before the Lord at the entrance of the tabernacle. The priest will take 1 of the male lambs and olive oil and present them as guilt offering, lifting them up as a special offering before the Lord. He will then slaughter the male lamb in a sacred area where sin offerings and burnt offerings are slaughtered. As without sin offering, the guilt offering belongs to the priest. It is most holy offering. The priest will then take some of the blood of the guilt of offering and apply it to the lobe of the right ear, the thumb of the right hand, and the big toe of the right foot of the person being purified. Then the priest will pour some of the olive oil into the palm of his left hand. He will dip his right finger into the oil in his palm and sprinkle some of it with his finger 7 times before the Lord. The priest will then apply some of the oil over the palm, over his palm, over the blood of the guilt offering that is on the lobe of the right ear, the thumb of the right hand, and the big toe of the right foot of the person being purified. The priest will then apply the oil remaining in his hand to the head of the person being purified. Through this process, the priest will purify the person before the Lord. Then the person must present the sin offering to purify the person who has cured of the skin disease. After that, the priest will slaughter the burnt offering and offer it on the altar along the grain offering. Through this process, the priest will purify the person who has healed, and the person will be ceremonially clean. But anyone who is too poor and cannot afford these offerings may bring one male lamb for guilt offering to be lifted up as a special offering for purification. The person must also bring 2 quarts of choice flour moistened with olive oil for grain offering as a cup of olive oil. The offering must also include 2 turtle doves or 2 young pigeons, whichever the person can afford. One of the pair must be used for sin offering and the other for burnt offering. On the 8th day of the purification ceremony, the person being purified must bring the offerings to the priest in the Lord's presence at the entrance of the tabernacle. The priest will take the lamb for the guilt offering along with the olive oil and lift them up as a special offering to the Lord. Then the priest will slaughter the lamb for the guilt offering. He will also take some of its blood and apply it to the lobe of the right ear, the thumb of the right hand, and the big toe of the right foot of the person being purified. The priest will also pour some of the olive oil into the palm of his own left hand. He will dip his right finger into the oil into his palm and sprinkle some of it 7 times before the Lord. The priest will then apply some of the oil in his palm over the blood of the guilt offering that is on the lobe of the right ear, the thumb of the right hand, and the big toe of the right foot of the person being purified. The priest will apply the oil remaining in his hand to the head of the person being purified. Through this process, the priest will purify the person before the Lord. Then the priest will offer the 2 turtle doves or 2 young pigeons, whichever the person can afford. One of them is for sin offering and the other is for burnt offering to be presented along with the grain offering. Through this process, the priest will purify the person before the Lord. These are the instructions for purification for those who have recovered from serious skin disease and who cannot afford to bring the offerings normally required for their ceremony purification. Then the Lord said to Moses and Aaron, "When you arrive to Canaan, the land I am giving you as your own possession, I may contaminate some of the houses in your land with mildew. The owner of such house must then go to the priest and say, 'It appears that my house has some kind of mildew.' Before the priest goes in to inspect the house, he must have the house emptied so nothing inside will be pronounced ceremonially unclean. Then the priest will go in and examine the mildew on the walls, and if he finds greenish or reddish streaks on the contamination appears to go deeper than the wall surface, then the priest will step outside the door and put the house in quarantine for 7 days. On the 7th day, the priest must return for another inspection. If he finds that the mildew on the walls of the house has spread, the priest must order that the stones from those areas be removed. The contaminated materials will then be taken outside the town to an area designated as ceremonially unclean. Next, the inside walls of the entire house must be scraped thoroughly, and scrapings dumped in the unclean place outside the town. Other stones will be brought in to replace the ones that were removed, and the walls will be replastered. But if the mildew reappears after the stones have been replaced and the house has been scraped and replastered, the priest must return and inspect the house again, and if he finds that the mildew has spread, the walls are clearly contaminated with serious mildew, and the house is defiled, it must be torn down, and all its stones, timbers, and plasters must be carried out of town to the place designated as ceremonially unclean. Those who enter the house during the period of quarantine will be ceremonially unclean until the evening, and all who sleep or eat in the house must wash their clothing. But if the priest returns for the inspection and finds that the mildew has not reappeared in the house after the fresh plastering, he will pronounce it clean because the mildew is clearly gone. To purify the house, the priest must take 2 birds, a stick of cedar, and some scarlet yarn and a hyssop branch. He will slaughter one of the birds over a clay pot filled with fresh water. He will take the cedar stick, the hyssop branch, the scarlet branch, and the live bird and dip them in the blood of the slaughtered bird and into the fresh water, and he will sprinkle the house 7 times. Then the priest have purified the house exactly this way. When the priest has purified the house in exactly this way, he will release the live bird in the open fields outside the town. Through this process, the priest will purify the house and it will be ceremonially clean. These are the instructions for dealing with serious skin diseases, including scabby sores and mildew, whether on clothing or in a house, and the swelling of the skin, a rash, or discolored skin. This procedure will determine whether a person or object is ceremonially clean or unclean. These are the instructions regarding the skin diseases and mildew. Wow. Thank you for reading along, and I'll see you tomorrow.